Today I am going to explain the poem The Snail written by William Cowper for class 10. So let's get started. This poem has both a surface and an inner meaning. To understand the inner meaning, my dear students, you should know William Cowper's life well. William Cowper was born in Berkhamsted, Hertfordshire, in England in 1731. He had lost his mother only at the age of 6. He was first enrolled in Westminster School in 1742 after moving from school to school for a number of years. He grew skilled as a Latin translator. After schooling, he was trained for a career in law. He suffered his first severe attack of depression at the failure of love with his cousin Theodora. He tried 3 times to commit suicide and was sent to an asylum at St. Albans for recovery. After his recovery, he settled with Molly Unwin and his wife Mary Unwin. After Molly Unwin's death, he continued to live in the Unwin home and became greatly attached to the widow Mary Unwin, who helped him to come out of his depression. They moved to Weston Underwood, Buckinghamshire, in 1786. Cowper started to translate Homer's Iliad and Odyssey into blank verse. Later, critics have faulted Cowper's Homer for being too much in the mold of John Milton. In 1795, Cowper and Mary moved to Norfolk and thereafter in many places as well. Mary Unwin died in 1796. This fact plunged him into darkness from which he never fully recovered. Cowper died in 1800. From the discussion of Cowper's life, you should keep in mind some points. First, throughout his life, he had no home. He ultimately lived alone and he is oversensitive. He suffered from mental illness and depression. Though critics made criticism for his Latin translation, yet he had great self-respect on himself. The snail much resembles the poet of sensibility. Let's begin the first stanza of the poem. To grass, to leaf or fruit or wall, the snail sticks close, nor fears to fall, as if he grew there, house and all, together. Now, the word meanings are sticks, be fixed, close, tightly, fall, to drop from higher to lower level. Grew means underwent natural development, together means collectively. Now we will learn the explanation of the first stanza. The snail sticks close to a grass blade or a leaf or a fruit or a wall. He is not afraid to drop from higher to lower level or in any kind of danger. It seems that he underwent natural development with his shell. In the first stanza, the poet William Cowper allows his readers to make an entry into the private and small yet safe and secure, tranquil world of the snail who lives a self-sufficient life. The tiny and simple snail's movement and attitude are prominently found here. The phrase house and all in line 3 misleads the reader. The snail is a natural part of the house whose wall he is affixed. This reading is corrected by that house in line 5. The real house of the snail is the one which surrounds and extends from his own body. Now let's move on to the second stanza. Within that house secured he hides, when danger imminent betides, of storm or other harm besides of weather. Word meaning: secure, safely, hides, conceals, danger, risk, imminent means ensuing or approaching, betides happens, storm refers to strong wind and rain, harm means damage. In time of any kind of ensuing danger, whether it is in the form of strong wind and rain or the slightest touch of anything like stick or stone or anyone, the snail conceals himself in his house for security. The phrase danger imminent shifts us from a material to spiritual register. The inversion of the phrase imminent danger hints at a spiritual, even allegorical reading of the snail as soul. Now look at the lines of the third stanza. Give but his horns the slightest touch, his self-collecting power is such, he shrinks into his house with much displeasure. Now, word meaning, the first word horns, look at the picture, you can see the horns of the snail. Horns means the head of the snail has one or two pairs of tentacles which have the eyes at the tips. The lower pair works as olfactory organs to smell. Slightest means minimal or very little. Touch, contact, self-collecting means gathering his everything by his own, here withdrawing oneself from one's surrounding. Look at the word power, POWR. This is the short form of the word power, POWER, means ability. This is the poetic use of the word. Shrinks means contracts or shortens. Displeasure means annoyance. If the snail's horns are given the slightest touch, he immediately shrinks with his self-collecting power into his shell with much annoyance. In other words, we can say when his loneliness is disturbed by any means, his attitude reveals much displeasure. Though the snail is normally judged as an insignificant, unimportant and insensible creature, but in this poem the poet portrayed him as a creature of extra sensibility. He is not unsocial but antisocial. He is not afraid of others' touch, but he objects others' intervention in his own isolated, private and self-sufficient world. In the third stanza, the language and allusions engineer a shift from the spiritual to the erotic. We witness the implicit meeting of the eyes of the snail extended on stalks and the eyes of the poet generously taking in the detail of the creature. Cowper's use of the word horns shared a curiosity about the natural world. He writes empathetically of the snail and perhaps would not have included its response to touch except for the literary precedent. Now let us explain the fourth stanza of the poem. Whenever he dwells alone, except himself, has chattels none, be satisfied to be his own whole treasure. Word meaning, wherever, look at the word wherever, apostrophe is given, W-H-E-R-E apostrophe E-R, full form wherever, this is the poetic use. Dwells means lives or resides. Chattels means personal possession. This is the important word, chattel. It is a special use. Chattel in dictionary, it spells chattel like C-H-A-T-T-E-L. But in your book, it is written as C-H-A-T-E-L-L. But both the word means the same thing. Now, satisfied means contented or pleased, treasure, valuables or wealth. The snail resides alone. He has no other personal possession except himself. But he is well contented with his own whole valuables. Now let us discuss the inner meaning of the poem. The snail partly symbolizes the poet William Cowper's sensitive life. Through his individual, simple but significant activities. The poet has been described as the poet of home life, but he never tasted pure domestic life. He remained unmarried and preferred to avoid the household responsibilities. The poem describes the poet's need to generate a personal homeliness during his time in Norfolk. The poet remained alone like the snail. He had self-respect for his work like the snail. The poet lived in a society, but consciously he separated himself from the monotonous routine work of everyday life. Moreover, like the snail, Cowper is easily injured, carefully observing the world with inquisitive and mobile eye stems, also self-possessed. The poem, as a translation and as a self-contained activity, reaffirms Cowper's identity as poet and reconnects him with poems and people. Thus, the self-collecting shell protects him from the cruelty of the world. Look at the poem once again. Let's discuss the structure of the poem now. The poem consists of 16 lines. Each stanza of the poem has three lines with one or two words in the fourth line. Originally, the poem consists of six quatrains, but in your book, it is of four quatrains. Do you know what is quatrain? Four lines in each stanza make a quatrain. Now, I'll read the first stanza of the poem once again. To grass or leaf or fruit or wall, the snail sticks close, nor fears to fall, as if he grew the house and all together. Now look at the rhyme scheme of the first stanza. Look at the last word of each line. Wall, fall, then how, then all, and finally together. So A, 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 B. This is the rhyme scheme for the first stanza. Similarly, you can see the last words of the second, third and fourth stanza. Then you will find the rhyme scheme is like that. C, 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 B for second stanza. D, 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 B for third stanza. And E, 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 B for fourth stanza. So, this is the rhyme scheme of the poem. Now, do you know what is a foot? The literary device foot is a measuring unit in poetry, which is made up of stressed and unstressed syllables. While reading the first stanza, you will notice some words are stressed and some words are not given the same stress. For example, the first line, to grass or leaf or fruit or wall. So to unstressed, then grass stressed or unstressed, leaf stressed or unstressed, fruit stressed, and finally or unstressed, while stressed. So when this kind of stressed, unstressed and stressed words are pronounced in a sentence or in a line of a poem, then the feet becomes feet is called iambic meter. And here 4 meters are found to grass first, or leaf second, or fruit third, and or wall fourth. So 4 meters, it is called tetrameter. So feet here is iambic tetrameter. Now let us discuss the significance of the title, The Snail. To give importance, article the is used before the word snail, or for a slow moving mollusk and his individual activities in his isolated, private, self-sufficient world. The poem is about the location of the snail's house, to grass or leaf or fruit or wall. His shell, where he finds comfort and conceals himself to survive from any kind of danger. The poem also highlights the virtue of snail's self-collecting power, his loneliness and his satisfaction for having no wealth except his personal belongings. To separate a snail from his house would surely be a futile effort. Thus, the poem appreciates all the qualities of an insignificant, tiny and simple creature like snail. Thus, the title is appropriate. Hope you guys like this video. For any query, feel free to ask me in the comment section. Like and share this video. Subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon to get the notifications first. So that's all. Bye.